But when flesh comes in, flesh will release signal to your mind. Mind will produce fear. And you say, you know what? I don't want to die. He's gone already. I don't want to go away like him. He's still alive. He's gone. Let me just protect my own life. He didn't. He started, he told me, I said, oh, he said it. He said, don't start no ministry until you endow with power. What is the source of that power? It's Holy Spirit. It's Holy Spirit that can make you to be bold as lion. It's Holy Spirit that can make you to take a decision that no human being have ever taken before. It's Holy Spirit that can make you to contact the wishes and say, keep quiet, you can't do nothing. Say me, I will show you. When you show me your grave, because you'll be dead. I said, but then he said, it's going to do something new. It will make a way for you where there's no way. Every door the enemies have shut. And you know our God is a God of open door.
Yes.
Revelation 3:7-9. Then I will open a door that no human being can shut. And whenever I shut any door, nobody can open it. So spiritually, financially, God is going to open a door for you today.
Yeah.
He said, forget it about the past. Don't dwell on the past no more. Your past failure, your past mistakes, your past having, forget about it. God, he said, your sins I will remember no more. If God said he's not going to remember your sins no more, because you are starting a new life with him, why are you still remembering your own sin? If God has forgiven you, why are you not forgiving yourself? Pastor, I have committed so many sins. When I was in secondary school, I had three abortions. Hey, don't you know me, Pastor? I have done this. The moment you confess your sins to the Most High God, that's the end of it. That's why as a Christian, you must not allow wishes and wisdom to rule over your life. Because the moment they give their life to God, that's the end. They are forgiven. It's true. So we want to kill me, I will kill them. He will give you a new name. That your life will no more be desolate. Your life will be productive. Spiritually, you'll be productive. Emotionally, you'll be productive.
Amen.
Intellectually, you'll be effective.
Amen.
There are people, when you see a tree, you must see the fruit. Mm-hmm. That is why this house was upset, because there was no fruit. It was just fleshy. There are some Christian fleshy. Not Adam, Mexico. I speak in tongues, so. I'm only going to blanket Christian. Show me your spirit. Show me the result. Bible says faith without result is dead. Which means God is not looking for someone without no result. He wants effectiveness. He wants productivity.
Amen.
So as a Christian, being called by a new name, that God is going to name you today, that your land will be no more desolate.
Amen.
Your land will be elsewhere.
Amen.
The Bible says you'll be beautiful and be prosperous.
Amen.
From now you'll be beautiful.
Amen.
And be prosperous.
Amen.
If maybe nobody has ever seen you that you are beautiful. Maybe people just say you are not beautiful. Say from now you the way you portray yourself, have you ever been to a fashion show before? Because the way you are going to carry yourself, as you will see yourself the way God sees you.
Yes.
And you behave because of the divine nature of God in you.
Yes.
The divine nature of God in you will eliminate your natural ways of doing things.
Yes.
And because the natural ways of doing things have been eliminated, you are not going to be operating in supernatural way. Supernatural way.
Yeah.
You see, the afternoon session is, I don't know. Maybe I'll be looking for pastor to take that over the afternoon and go for the morning.
No.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Are you okay?
Yes.
Okay, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Isaiah 61, tell them. It has turned your ashes into what it will be.
Yes.
The ugliness. Who could have believed that Michelle Obama is as beautiful as this? Let me tell you, everybody is beautiful.
Oh, yes.
When situation changes, circumstances, everybody's handsome. Beautiful and handsome. Because your wardrobe is going to change.
Yes, yes. Yes.
Look at her now. When you just put that ritual and say, ah, ah. I remember that woman that my husband was saying, she doesn't look like the first lady. I said, when he got there, it's going to look like that. Like 5 years ago, could have been. He doesn't look like one. He does not even have, she does not even have to dress at that time. Look at her. Because she has someone that will decorate her, someone that will tell her what to do. And look at her, man. It just be like a model now. God can transform life.
Yes.
God can reshape life.
Yes.
God can transform situations and circumstances. That people will look at you and say, ah, you look like so-so. Oh, you look like Mrs. Schroeder. No, you want to confuse someone. You say, oh, Mrs. Schroeder. Oh, that one. I say, eh. Oh, by the grace of God, I'm Mrs. Schroeder. Are you the one? No, that was ah. So, because when God beautifies your life, when God changes your circumstances, what they are supposed to see, they will see it.
Yes.
They will see the glory of God.
Yes.
They will see the grace of God.
Yes.
They will see the favor of God.
Yes.
Then he said, you shall be called by what? A new name. A new name said that, I can see the glory of God upon you.
Yes.
I can see the favor of God upon you. That's a new name. A new name is that, when a new name is given, everything will change.
Yes.
The way you do your business, I will change.
Yes.
You will see new management. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Everything will be changed. And that is what is going to happen in the name of Jesus Christ. Then the realm we are right now is the realm that you are going to benefit from the blessing that have been endowed into the land of America.
Amen.
You are looking at that. What blessing? There is a blessing here.
Yes.
Let's read Isaiah 61:6. And Isaiah 1:17 to it said, if you are willing and obedient, you will eat the best of the land. There are some best assigned to this land.
Yes.
Isaiah 61:6.
And you will be called priest of the Lord.
Can you say, I will be called priest of the Lord.
You will be named ministers of God.
Can you say, you will be named addicted Christian of the Lord.
Yes.
Follower of Jesus Christ. People that will be not mistaken, is she really a Christian? And you see someone said, is she really a Christian? Because all the attributes, all the characteristics, all the qualities does not portray a Christian.
Yes.
Some say, if Christianity is like that, I'm not going to church. Some of our behavior have sent people away. Our attitude at work. Some of us, they are not even proclaiming the thing at work that we are Christian. Because the way we are nagging, complaining, you cannot even do extra favor for someone for 1 minute. But from now, things will change.
Amen.
All those prayers will be over.
Amen.
All those stress will be over.
Amen.
You don't smile because you are stressed, you are pressed down. Eh? You start smiling, right?
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You say, oh, Pastor, how are you? Good morning. Everything. No, you relax.
Yes.
Say, I'm ready to relax. Smile and let me see you. Okay, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Continue.
You will feed on the wealth of nations.
Amen.
How many of you is going to feed on the wealth of nations?
Amen.
There are some wealth in this land.
Yes.
You know what? Sit down. You know what? You don't need to go to Australia, to Canada, anywhere you are because of the DNA of Abraham that is already in you.
Yes.
You must be wealthy.
Yes.
It does not glorify God for us to be in lack.
Yes.
It does not glorify God. Okay, for example, if you see one of my children in clubhouse, how will you feel? If you see one of my children just wearing rag, I know one of you said, Sean, follow me to the store. You see me, I beat you tomorrow, right? Because you know it does not glorify your pastor. So, also God wants something that glorifies him in your life. When people say, you are